Hello and welcome to the second PrusaPrinters Developer Log. The first one was very well received and you asked for more, so we're back to show you what we're working on. The most useful addition is sorting by popularity in the past week and month to the current all-time metric. The time dimension will be available for all metrics where it makes sense, which is sorting by most downloaded, most liked, most viewed, and top rated prints. This will make it much easier to discover cool prints. We decided to go for a floating time frame. What that means is that most liked this week represents the last 7 days and it changes every day, rather than representing a fixed calendar week. Also, these metrics are calculated on all models, so even if the model is 1 year old, if it suddenly receives a lot of likes or downloads, for example by being featured in a video, it will go up in the list. So unlike the all-time metric, these lists will change all the time, and we hope they'll be a good source of inspiration for new prints. Adding this feature was heavily requested both on our social media and using the form on PrusaPrinters. If you have any feedback, one of the ways to send it to us is using this button on PrusaPrinters homepage. The second series of changes revolve around our designer contests. We're always blown away by how many and how great models you guys submit. The last contest with the organization team had nearly 1200 submissions. We've prepared a new page with an overview of all contests. The currently running contests are displayed on top, and you can clearly see how much time you have left to participate. You can click on the competition to find out more information about it and to see the current submissions. Beneath the active contests are those that have already finished. And they are still very useful because they're essentially really big collections of prints with a specific topic. You'll be able to see all of them on this new page, and you'll see thumbnails of the winning designs. If you open it, you'll see the winning designs in more detail on top, and then all of the other submissions. The winning designs get this nice permanent badge. It's visible everywhere in the market. And if you hover your mouse over it, you'll get the name of the competition, and if you click on it, it will take you to the competition page. Up until now, we used the Add to Collection button to submit a print to a contest, but now we have a dedicated button for it on the Print Detail page. We will keep organizing more contests where you can win printers, filaments, and vouchers for our eShop. For example, right now, we're running a competition with the team Gardening Tools. The third thing that we have reworked is the filtering system on the market. If you select a file type, it will now only show you filters available for that file type. So if you select 3D models, you can show only models from authors that you're following, or for example, you can only show featured prints. If we select G-codes, there's more filters available now. We can select a printer, the original Prusa Mini, PLA filament, and 0.4mm nozzle. And you will now see that the filters also appear on top. That's quite handy. If you open some print and you browse it for a while and then you go back, you could forget about those filters and that you're only seeing some prints. So now you will always be reminded of them. You can clear them one by one, or you can just easily remove all of them. Similarly, if you select SLA print files and you add some kind of filter, it will show on top and you can easily clear it. One more little addition, all categories now have a short description that describe the prints in it. Let us know in the comments how you like these changes, and as always, happy printing!